Welcome to Cincinnati, Ohio, in one of college basketball's most intense non-conference dogfights. Nowhere else are there two schools of this caliber, this close together, slugging it out annually. The University of Cincinnati has generally been the high-profile, swaggering power, while Xavier has been the little school that could, pulling the upset. Now, roles are reversed, as ninth-ranked Xavier has made the three-mile trip as a favorite. It'll be physical, intense, and fun, but who will have bragging rights in the Queen City? Find out next. This isn't just some neighborhood squabble. This is something different. It's the annual Crosstown Shootout. Cincinnati's battle for bragging rights. Two schools a few miles apart. Number 9, Xavier and Cincinnati, a great city rivalry. You better have the chin stripe extra tight for this one. Hi, everybody. I'm Dave O'Brien, along with Jay Billis. Jay, we've had the pleasure, both of us, of calling this game before. It's a great treat. It means so much to both schools. But for Cincinnati, trying to regain some national relevance in college basketball, does it mean even more to them?
Well, Mick Cronin has told his team that it does. Cincinnati wants back on the national stage. They want to be ranked. He has told his team that being Xavier is just a bonus as our opponent. They want to win this game and establish themselves as a national power again. It's the first step toward that tonight.
Let's get to Star Watch now. A couple of junior leaders in Deontay Vaughn and Derrick Brown.
Well, Derrick Brown, a lefty, very athletic. He is now healthy after suffering an ankle injury earlier in the season. And Deontay Vaughn, he's their leading scorer, leads them in assists. He has got to be a leader on the floor, especially for the younger players that Cincinnati puts out there.
The Xavier starting lineup. Jason Love is the big man at 6'9". The guards are big two, Dante Jackson and B.J. Raymond. C.J. Anderson, the other 40s, averaging 11 points, 5 rebounds. For Cincinnati, you can't miss the man-child, the prodigy, a Cincinnati high school star, 6'9", Yancey Gates, senior Mike Williams and Rashad Bishop with him in the front court, and Larry Davis joins Vaughn in the backcourt. Sean Miller, the Xavier head coach, they're off to a great start, 8-0. He says he loves the Crosstown Shootout, and he'd better. He signed a new 10-year contract in April. He could be coaching this game through 2018.
That's a lot of chili, baby.
Take a look at the series history, and it really has been a dandy. Seems every game goes right down to the final moments. They started playing it in 1928. Cincinnati leads it all time, but Xavier has taken 8 of the last 12 games. Last year, Xavier won it 64-59. That game was tied at 53 with about 2.5 minutes to play. And they really get after it hard. There's usually some blood on the floor. They're both playing very well, as you can see right now. Best winning percentage going into the Shootout that they have ever had at 93%.
Dante Jackson doing a terrific job putting pressure on Deontay Vaughn.
Williams got it underneath to the big fella, Yancey Gates, and he strikes, and Cincinnati fans want to see a lot of that in this rivalry in the years to come. One of the most talented freshmen in the country.
The big guys for Cincinnati have bulk. They can block shots, and they can really rebound. It will be important for Xavier to be able to hang on the glass with an outstanding rebounding team.
Brown at the top of the key now for Xavier in the blue, and Raymond casts up the first jump shot a little bit short. Gates could not control it, and so Xavier will keep it here in the opening minutes at Fifth Third Arena. Nobody wearing white in this one.
Kind of like UCLA, USC in football. They're willing to lose a timeout to wear their road colors. Already you can see that nobody is guarding C.J. Anderson out on the perimeter.
Brown, the jump shot looked good coming off his hand. Jackson will swing it back up top to Derrick Brown. He's averaging 13 points per game and usually hits the three-pointers that he does take. Well, back down here by C.J. Anderson and a quick move inside.
See, it's so difficult. When you back off of a shooter that far like Deontay Vaughn just did, it's really easy for that guy to get into you and reassume that space. That's exactly what C.J. Anderson did and just backed him in.
Cincinnati with wins over UAB and UNLV among their 6 victories. Their only loss so far, low-scoring affair to Florida State. They lost that game 58-47. 12 on the shot clock for Vaughn. Bishop will dump it for the big man. Gates, a little too strong. That didn't touch anything. 2 to shoot. It didn't touch. Got to get the shot off, but there is a violation, and they did not get it off in time. The shot clock expired. There's Mick Cronin in his third year.
You can see Deontay Vaughn staying way off of Anderson there, just daring him to shoot it. And Jackson, or Anderson, just did a great job of getting into that space. He assumed all that space and got into him. And what Xavier does, Dave, they do a great job of posting their guards. They post just about everybody, and they shoot 35 free throws per game. Cincinnati has to play really good defense without fouling.
Jackson straight on, drains the three. Beautiful touch there by Dante Jackson, and that is how he says his first name. 6'5", sophomore out of Greenfield, Ohio.
And Dante Jackson has got to do a good job of handling pressure, because Cincinnati is going to try to bring some heat on him throughout this game.
Vaughn, the number two Big East three-point shooter last year. That shot catches a lot of iron and right into the hands of the Xavier Musketeers, who set a school record with 30 wins last year. Jackson with a little bump, a little shove there. I don't think we're going to hear a whole lot of whistles, because they will let them play.
Right now, Xavier's brought a little bit more energy to start this game. A little bit surprising. It looks like Cincinnati, especially a couple of their younger players, trying to feel their way around this game.
Outstanding crew, Tim Higgins, John Cahill, and Carl Hess. They have officiated a combined 21 Final Fours and 9 national championship games.
Well, we need 3 Green Berets to ref this game.
Raymond will call out a play. B.J. Raymond, the senior.
Oh, that flat ball screen.
Anderson on the baseline. Into the corner here for Jackson. This one short. Nancy Gates with the board. Could be a giant factor in this one. Cincinnati trying to get back onto the national screen after a 13-19 season last year. The crowd howling for a foul underneath.
Well, nice job by Jason Love and Derrick Brown to get a hand on that ball.
Jason Love fouled as he lunged after the pass. And Yancey Gates in there to commit his first foul with 16:51 to play in the first half right here on the University of Cincinnati campus.
Xavier does such a good job defensively. They don't really get out and deny passes, but they're there on the catch. They really kind of build a wall and make it very difficult for you to get an uncontested shot.
Gates hits the bench. A 7-footer Anthony McLean is on. And Xavier casting up an air ball, and the Bearcats trying to get a little bit bigger inside that paint, if not necessarily more rugged. That's something they're trying to get McLean to do, really use his size and throw some elbows on occasion. Here's Bishop, too strong with the three, and a rebound torn down by Derrick Brown.
Nice little pop back, but the lefty just missed it.
Anderson baseline, bodying up on Bishop, who denies him and blocked the shot out of bounds. A tough defensive stop there.
Cincinnati does a very nice job with their length and athleticism of blocking and altering shots. And C.J. Anderson just got caught a little bit too far underneath the backboard. And when he tried to maneuver the ball, he opened it up for the shot block.
Xavier will counter with Kenny Freeze, a 7-footer in his own right. He's a freshman. And Sean Miller has said he's as talented as any freshman ever on campus. And a long bomb will fall by Terrell Holloway, a 6-foot freshman who missed a couple of games early with a stress fracture, but playing well again.
Well, he really changes the speed of the game for Xavier. He is quicker and faster than Dante Jackson and brings a different element.
Vaughn tried the baseline pass and quickly stolen away. It was Holloway to get his hand on it, and then he threw the pass out of bounds. Xavier on top here in the early minutes, 8-2, and a very talented youngster, Terrell Holloway, is averaging 7 a game, an early bomb for him in the rivalry.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Heineken.
It has already been a big day at the University of Cincinnati. That was earlier today, graduation for those graduating in December here at UC. And by noontime, the ceremony was over. Of course, got to flip that tassel. And then they went to work getting the floor ready for basketball, and they did a spectacular job.
How'd you like to graduate right now in this job market?
Yeah, he looked like he was having a lot of fun as he walked up there, but a job well done by everybody here at the university. For the Bearcats, a 6-1 start, including a couple of very impressive wins in Puerto Rico against Virginia Tech and Memphis. I should say Xavier did, and they lost freshman Cashmere Wright to the ACL early, and he is not able to go with them. He's going to redshirt here in his what would have been his first year, one of the top recruits in the country. There's Vaughn straight on. Too short, and a big battle for the rebound. Anderson comes away with it on the baseline.
Well, Cincinnati's had some opportunities to get offensive rebounds. They just didn't get it, and Xavier really punished him in transition for it.
Three's able to dunk off a nifty bounce pass. And they're out in front 10-2. And Cincinnati would win over UAB and UNLV early on. Xavier and Cincinnati both off to outstanding starts. Williams with the foul will be his first. Mike Williams with the personal.
This Xavier team is so solid, already knocking Cincinnati at home back on their heels. They're very good offensively. Not a great shooting team, but they set a ton of back screens. They run their stuff, and there's the heat that Cincinnati wanted to bring. Bad pass.
Well, Gates had a chance with Vaughn out in front, but he threw it wildly off his hand. Otherwise, it's an easy transition basket off the theft. And a recap on Xavier. By the way, they're 5-0 against Cincinnati when they come into this game, nationally ranked, but really shutting people down. That field goal defense, one of the best in the country.
High screen, they are doubling off of it. And Holloway going to have to do a better job of handling that pressure. Got trapped the first time they ran that play and coughed it up and almost threw it away the second time.
Raymond and Anderson coming off now for Sean Miller. Derrick Brown, a 6'8 junior, to check it in. One of the better wingmen you're going to see all season long. Here's Holloway to call out a play. An outstanding start for the Musketeers here. Holloway outside the three to the seven-footer. Freeze on the baseline, working against Yancey Gates. Got off that pass. And now look at Freeze hit the deck. Look at the big man go down on the loose ball.
Well, that's what this rivalry is all about. Ball's on the floor, everybody gets down for it. And Freeze was the first one on the deck.
Bishop trying to cut into that lane. Lost the handle. Slapped away from him. McLean comes away with it. Five turnovers already for Cincinnati. Holloway.
Nothing there.
That's going to be a charge. Offensive foul on Terrell Holloway.
Just a freshman mistake by Terrell Holloway. Taking the ball into too much traffic. And Alvin Mitchell just lost it off his back foot. And Freeze, the first one on the deck, and too many red shirts to take the ball to the hole like that in transition. Got to be smarter and use that free throw line as a stop sign.
So here we are, about 6 minutes in. Cincinnati has one bucket. And shooting was a big problem for Mick Cronin's team last year. It's improved slightly. Vaughn, too strong from the corner. Rebound loose at the top of the key and taken in by the Musketeers.
Xavier will be able to get some opportunities in transition if they continue to rebound defensively. They've got to send all five guys to the defensive glass because Cincinnati is such a good offensive rebounding team.
And Dixon with the foul on Dante Jackson. That'll be number one on the freshman from Chicago. And once again, McLean will re-enter the fray here.
It's not like Cincinnati has played poorly on the defensive end. They've just put a lot of pressure on their defense. Great play out of bounds.
McLean went for the block from behind, and he commits the foul. 13:42 to go in the opening half. His first.
Xavier does such a nice job. You see a little back pick here, and will turn and go off that pick. And nobody communicates. That was for Deion Dixon to pick up, get his chest on that cutter, Freeze, and he didn't do it.
Freeze, a true back to the basket post player. Averaged 21 points, 12 rebounds at Perry High School in Ohio. Tallest player ever at Xavier. His mom, Margaret, was also a center at Youngstown State. There's going to be a foul in the lane against Cincinnati.
No, they had a violation.
A violation.
Vaughn stepped in early, just got his right foot in, and John Cale saw it right away.
So Freeze to do it again here. An 8-point lead for Xavier. I think that's the reason that Freeze wears the number 32. His mom wore it in college. And they pay for the lane violation. Now 11-2.
Cincinnati needs to get something easy. Throw the ball inside and see if they can either get an easy score or get to the free throw line.
Vaughn to drive, takes the lane and travels with it. He walked to give it back and is still frozen at 2 points.
Well, one of the problems for Cincinnati, it's all off of one pass right now. They've got to move this defense because Xavier does a great job with their help side. They've got a great gap presence. You're basically looking at five Xavier chests when you try to drive.
And Cincinnati scored about 24 seconds into the game, and they have not scored since then. Mitchell reaching in with a foul. Although Mick Cronin liked that effort, the third-year head coach and a former Bob Huggins and Rick Pitino assistant. Had some good teachers.
He has. He's done a very good job. A really good recruiter. And had a big job when he took over here at Cincinnati. But he's done a nice job of bringing the Bearcats back.
38 years old. Xavier with the ball here. Jackson out high. Brown wants to shoot it. The lefty knocks it down. Smooth stroke there from about 15. That is really quiet at this crowd at the University of Cincinnati. They're going to let the referees hear it a little bit, but Cincinnati is not scoring. 13-2 Xavier. Back in Cincinnati, Xavier on top with 13 minutes to go before halftime. And Tuesday night on ESPN2 and ESPN, catch a college hoops doubleheader from the Big East SEC Invitational from Nashville. First at 7 Eastern on ESPN2, South Florida and Vanderbilt. Then at 9:30, Marquette against Tennessee. Tennessee going down in an upset today. There's a holding foul away from the basketball. This will go against Xavier. And the crowd derisive with their applause.
Now just the second team foul on Xavier. Five already for Cincinnati. And one thing that Cincinnati doesn't want to do, and that's put Xavier on the free throw line. Xavier shoots a ton of free throws. That's part of their game.
Foul on Jason Love, his first. And Xavier will have it back here. Seven turnovers updated now for the Bearcats. Make it seven.
Cincinnati just seems out of sync. And you got to give Xavier credit with their defense for putting them back on their heels and out of sync, but that was a walk that Xavier got away with there.
Love winds up getting fouled, but they missed the travel before that. Jackson dragged that foot. Cronin definitely saw it. His dad is in the stands tonight. We talk about his great teachers. His father, Harold, a legendary high school coach here in Cincinnati. And there he is, one of the all-time greats here. Getting a chance to watch his son work, although not real happy with the results so far. Love knocks down the first one, a 73% foul shooter. Over 400 wins as a high school coach in Cincinnati. So Mick Cronin certainly has a special feel for this rivalry between Cincinnati and Xavier. Around and out by Love. Cincinnati trying to do something to get this sold-out house involved here on campus.
And one of the ways they can get going is get to the free throw line.
The swing here for Davis, and he knocks it down from three-point land. Larry Davis only connected on 31% of his threes, but that one brings them to life a little bit.
Well, one of the few times that Cincinnati's gotten ball movement from side to side, and magically they get a wide open shot and knock it down. Now they need to score again and get their own little run.
We'll see if Vaughn can continue the momentum. Gates will pull up and shoot. That's off the back iron. 14-5, number 9 Xavier in command of this one early. And a big drive and one as well on a terrific move there by C.J. Anderson. Showing off some real strength with 4 points, trying to make it five.
Not a priority for Cincinnati to get back. Everybody left the ball and C.J. Anderson took advantage of it.
back in Cincinnati, and Xavier with a 16-5 lead over the Bearcats. And Jay Billis, let's go inside the play here.
Xavier is a really good defensive team. They play man-to-man defense. They're head on the ball. They pressure the ball, but they're very help side oriented, kind of a pack line defense. We can start it here and take a look with Cincinnati. They're not denying any passes here. They're just right in front. They stay with their man. And let's freeze it right here. You can see they're right in the gap. They're right there in the post, looking at the ball right there. There's nowhere for Cincinnati to go. When they do drive it, they drive it right into help, right into that gap presence, and everybody surrounds the ball. That's great defense by Xavier. They don't get too spread out on the weak side. They sit in those gaps, and it's very difficult to drive on the Musketeers, an outstanding defensive team.
C.J. Anderson trying to complete the three-point play, cannot. He was fouled by Mike Williams right in front of the break. Cincinnati has already committed seven fouls, so very quickly, one-and-one time for Xavier. And another whistle. This one will go against the Musketeers. With 11:37 to go in half number one. In a game that traditionally around this time is nip and tuck, it's usually dead even. It's always been very close.
Well, even though it's an 11-point deficit, that's really not that much. Cincinnati's just got to stay strong and start executing offensively. Their defense hasn't been bad, even though they fouled a little bit too much.
Vaughn off to Bishop. Vaughn, long, long three. And a big rebound by B.J. Raymond, the 6'6 senior, who scored 32 against Auburn. Here's Raymond. He can do that. He can hit the three-pointer. Ricochets right back to Cincinnati, though.
I think Cincinnati can still look to get the ball inside, especially to Yancey Gates. He is big, he is strong, and he can score. But they've got to take advantage of punching that ball inside and then kicking it back out again.
And Terrell Holloway to the bench.
Once Vaughn gives the ball up, he operates as a two-guard and looks to score.
Wilts, and as you said, Yancey Gates getting a touch.
He's catching it too far outside the lane. Jason Love doing a very nice job of pushing him out.
Bishop on a strong drive. He started the first six games of the season for the Bearcats, but has been coming off the bench.
Bishop is a good role player, good defender. See how he's playing that far off of C.J. Anderson?
Brown pulls up and leaves it short. Anderson with the board. They'll get a new shot clock here. Xavier not looking like they're in any hustle right now. That's going to be a traveling violation. Back over to the Bearcats it goes.
Jackson just found himself a little bit too far under the bucket. That was a good pass. And Brown does a nice job with shot fakes and ball fakes. He needs to continue to do that because Cincinnati is leaving the floor on those fakes.
Cincinnati has lately shown the ability to shock high-ranked opponents. They did it to Louisville at Freedom Hall last year. They also beat number 11 Pitt on this court in January and knocked off number 19 Villanova as well. So here on top, 16-7.
Jason Love just went out of the ball game. Did a terrific job of guarding Yancey Gates in the post. And right now with Kenny Freeze on him, I think the Gates really has to do a good job of posting.
Whistle and a foul against Cincinnati. And they're coming well off the ball. We have seen that look on Mick Cronin's face several times already. Wilkes with his first foul.
He's got Wilkes with an extended arm on a screen.
Fouls are coming fast and furious for the men in red in the opening half. Anderson jumps. Blocked away from him. Bishop backs him down. Back and he goes. Swooping with that right hand. What a beautiful move.
Acrobatic in the post. And C.J. Anderson operates very effectively down in the post. He can post a guard. And most guards aren't used to playing post defense. And he can either score or get fouled, or oftentimes both.
Deshaun Miller has said of him that the bigger the game, the bigger he plays, the better he plays.
Just a weak pass by Deontay Vaughn.
Jackson picks that off. 18-7. Usually this rivalry doesn't see scores like this in the first half, as Jackson will bring it back out now for number 9 Xavier. And another whistle. And yet another foul against the Bearcats. Back to Anderson, though.
C.J. Anderson, a slasher, but see how he backs his man in here and just goes against a smaller guard that's not used to guarding in the post. And they made him score over, and he certainly did that. What a nice move and finish. Very difficult off the glass.
Gates just picked up his third foul. And Tim Higgins over there with John Cahill. I think somebody just got hit with a technical foul on the Cincinnati side. Maybe Gates. And indeed it is. So he's getting a little bit frustrated. The young man, the 6'9", 260-pound freshman, Yancey Gates.
Was Gates after the last play, and just a little bump with Kenny Freeze, and apparently there's a, well, a headbutt. Yeah, we don't need that. This rivalry is so intense. Guys get to talking and running their mouths, and that can lead to some bad outcomes.
And Jamel McClain at the line, where he scuffles only 40% back to that headbutt.
Yeah, you were just joking at the top of the broadcast about, you know, getting that chin strap tighter and, you know, having to wear a helmet. But geez, you almost need one in this game. It looked like Freeze was the one that hit him with his head. Just a little love tap. That's something that, even though that was not a in the grand scheme of things, a big deal, I think that's something that both conference offices need to look at.
Wilkes fires it up. That one too strong. Cincinnati crashing the boards, trying to win it back, but can't. That's going to be a traveling violation, however, on Xavier. So the hustle pays off there.
Rashad Bishop really climbed the ladder to go after that offensive rebound and went after it with both hands. Cincinnati has had their fingers on a number of offensive boards, but haven't been able to corral them. They need to start grabbing those. Because that's one of the ways they score. They're not a great shooting team, but if they can get second chance opportunities, when you miss one, you put in the second chance, that's 50%.
On hand, the lane gives it up to Davis. They have forced that shot, but the rebound and the foul against the Musketeers. Darnell Wilkes working hard underneath there, the rather slippery 6'7 sophomore out of Nashville.
Darnell Wilkes is a big-time athlete. A high flyer. Had a very good game against UAB. Knocked down a couple of threes. Used his athleticism. He's not particularly strong, but very quick.
Freeze with his first foul to send Wilkes to the line here at 8:42 left in half number one.
You see Jason Love coming back in. He's a very good post defender and such a hard worker. You know, Xavier, in their practices, they have a gold jersey. And whoever has the best week of practice, worked the hardest, it's an honor that they get to wear that gold jersey in practice. And this week, it was Jason Love. And it's often Jason Love or C.J. Anderson on this team.
Jackson hustling into the offensive zone. They get Brad Redford, a 6-foot freshman, into the ball game. Brown on the wing. Love with the touch. He's 6'9". Swoops it up there. Too strong. Pretty ugly offensive numbers for Cincinnati in the early going. Lots of fouls, lots of turnovers, Jay.
Yeah, it's not been their defense. Their defense has been pretty good. I mean, they've held Xavier 19 points, but their offense has been poor. I mean, they've had some open shots they've missed, but they've also turned it over. And that's, you know, that's a turnover as well, to foul on the offensive end like that. Just setting a bad screen. Set a good screen and let your teammate use it.
Wilkes' second foul. The Cincinnati sophomore. And they're still not into double figures in scoring. And we've got 8 minutes left in the half. And another whistle. This one against the Xavier Musketeers. So those are really starting to pile up and get a little bit annoying here. Well, those fans are in the way to the score. 19-9 Xavier. Gee, Billis, it feels like a lot more than a 10-point game, doesn't it?
It really does. And if Cincinnati can just get something good to happen on the offensive end, they'll be right back in this. I mean, Cincinnati has more turnovers than points. Usually say more turnovers than field goals about how a team playing poorly. More turnovers than points is highly unusual for anybody.
And another whistle. There's 7:50 remaining in the first half here from Fifth Third Arena.
So far, the officials have been the stars. Called their names more than anybody else's.
Tim Higgins, John Cahill, Carl Hess buckling down on this one. That personal foul on Redford will be his first. And so it's Dixon to the line. Got his first college start last week against UAB. Scored 5 points in 21 minutes. Out of Chicago's Crane Technical Prep. A 1-1, first one drops.
And thus far in the game, Deontay Vaughn, the leading scorer for Cincinnati, has yet to scratch. Not a single point. 0 of 3 from the field. And he needs to get off the snide and start contributing on the offensive end.
Dixon, a rookie, with a good touch at the line, and now they're within 8. Long over to McLean, looking inside.
Nice back pick by Holloway to get Brown into the low post. Not a good shot by Xavier.
Love straight on, but missed it. Got a very good look. Bishop finds Vaughn. Deontay Vaughn, 14 points per game. A pass off Cincinnati. Well, tomorrow night on ESPN at 8:30 Eastern, Matt Weiner is hosting Bowl Mania. Jesse Palmer ranking all 34 bowl games. The game day crew making their picks. Todd McShay identifies a few under-the-radar NFL prospects to watch during the bowl season. And Cincinnati's going bowling as well, going to the Orange Bowl. And there's Connor Barwin, who's in the student section. Recruited to Cincinnati as a football tight end. But after the basketball roster was decimated following Bob Huggins' departure, he filled in as a big man during two hoop seasons.
And did a good job.
Wow. McLean, yes, trying to back down, and he's walking with it. Jamel McLean. Barwin in action. He's showing those muscles, but on the basketball floor. He still used those pass-catching skills this last season. Caught a touchdown against South Florida. He's an NFL future pick as well, predicted to play in the National Football League. A very good defensive end.
They probably like basketball a little bit better. Not quite as physical and not as many bad bounces with the round ball.
Now Raymond with his first foul to put Vaughn to the line. First team all Big East last season, was the league's number 5 scorer at 17 a game.
Anytime, Dave, that you have a scorer like Deontay Vaughn that has not gotten on the board and is struggling, the last thing you want to do is foul.
And he still hasn't scored in this one.
You don't want to let a good player who's struggling get a chance to see the ball go through the net. Nice move.
Brown tried to follow, missed the dunk, and he tips that one up and over the backboard. So it's back to the Bearcats here, and they're within 8.
Well, it's been Xavier that's been a little bit tougher on the glass in this game than Cincinnati has been. Cincinnati needs to get a shot every time down. There's still 6.5 minutes left in this first half, and they're only 8 points down, even as poorly as they've played offensively.
Steve Toiloy into the ball game. He's a 6'8 junior for Cincinnati. On to Dixon, a catch and shoot. He's fouled in the act of firing up a 3. Holloway jumped out and hacked him.
Not a good foul by Terrell Holloway. Think about how many times as a defender you block a jump shot. You want to get late pressure, but you certainly don't want to foul a jump shooter and send him to the free throw line. And especially Cincinnati is struggling so badly. You let him go to the line and watch that ball go through the net, you're just asking for it.
That's how they're working their way back into this thing. Holloway just picked up his 3rd, so he's in trouble with 6:18 to go in the half. Deion Dixon back to the line for the 2nd one. And has another one coming. And Holloway will step out. And back on Jason Love. He was probably Xavier's best rebounder. So Dixon with another one coming here. And as badly as Cincinnati has struggled offensively, Dixon makes all three at the line, and this is a five-point game.
And now all of a sudden Cincinnati has something to feel good about, and they are aggressively going after the ball, and a foul by Wilkes just trying to stay in front of Dante Jackson. Jackson has done a pretty good job. He backed it up, and you can see he just stayed with the drive. And there was contact. I'm not sure that initial guarding position had been established. So I think it was a good call, just a tough one to swallow for a coach that's asking his team to get out and really defend and put the heat on a ball handler that has been having some problems handling the ball this season.
Wilkes with his third quick foul coming off the bench, sending Dante Jackson to the line. Good passer, solid rebounder, not a big scorer. He is 72% at the line. Hit the biggest shot of his career in Xavier's NCAA win over Georgia last spring. A three-pointer late in that game put him up for good, and they went on to the win. Xavier, an elite 18 last spring.
They had a magnificent year last year, 30-7. And Sean Miller's just done a great job with this program.
They knocked out Georgia, Purdue, and West Virginia in overtime in the tournament, eventually falling in the regional final to Phoenix. Toilet kicks it out, wants it back. One dribble down. Looked good coming off the hand, but it does not fall for him.
The Toilet wasn't ready for the ball the first time he caught it. He should have been able to lay that in if he were prepared when that ball arrived.
Cronin wanted to travel on Jackson, and frankly, they've missed a couple of those here in the first half. Jackson will drive the baseline. Here's Raymond. Around and out with the three.
And Raymond's such a good shooter when he has his feet set, and his feet were set on that with the cross-court pass.
Bishop off to Dixon, who's really got involved in the offense here. Deontay Vaughn wriggles in with a right hand, lays it in. Strong move.
Derrick Brown lost vision on the ball, couldn't get over to that drive. And all of a sudden, we got ourselves a ball game again.
Follow a shot right on the money by Derrick Brown. So smooth, the left-handed shooter, and a timeout.
Derrick Brown looks so much better than he did a week ago, struggling with that ankle injury. He feels 100% now.
Preseason all A-10 first team. Hey, Tuesday night at ESPN2 and ESPN. A College Hoops doubleheader coming your way. The Big East SEC Invitational from Nashville. First at 7 Eastern on ESPN2. South Florida and Vanderbilt. And then at 9:30 Eastern on ESPN, it's Marquette squaring off against Tennessee. The Volunteers trying to regroup after an upset loss today.
Well, and they're going to get a really good tandem of guards when they face Marquette. Marquette not only has Dominic James, who's been an outstanding player for the Golden Eagles for quite some time, but Jarrell McNeil and Wesley Matthews are playing very, very well.
We talk about the Crosstown Shootout, just how close Xavier and Cincinnati are. Look at the map of Cincinnati. That's, what, 3 miles. And you look at the other schools, notable distances, and some other pretty good rivalries like the one you were part of.
Yeah, that 11.4 miles seems like a longer distance. Worlds apart. And neither of these teams are going to be having Christmas dinner together, I know that. Two-three zone right now. No, actually, it's man. That's how much they sit in those gaps. It looked like zone.
And Vaughn gives it up. Bishop got airborne. Here's Vaughn in the corner. He knocks down a three. That's a little more like it for Bearcat fans. They're back to within five.
And let's see if that gets Deontay Vaughn going a little bit. He is too good of a scorer to be as quiet as he has been.
Brown wants to shoot it. Rainbow three. Too short.
Not a good shot.
Rebound batted on the baseline, and Xavier will have it.
Derrick Brown took that shot off of one pass. When they have moved the ball and moved it from side to side, they've given the defense a chance to break down. When you move the ball from side to side, Dave, you can really give a weak defender the chance to make a mistake.
Brown up top to Anderson. Here's Raymond. The swing, Jackson. His three will rattle in.
Xavier there. Derrick Brown had the ball on the right side of the floor. Could have taken a shot, but they moved the ball around the horn. And then Dante Jackson got to step into a shot. Any shooter stepping into a shot is a better shooter.
Vaughn thought he had a better stroke. Not on this occasion. Jackson is left open. And another one knocked down from high on the wing. He has 11.
One of the best times to take a three is in transition. And Xavier brought it up the right side, and Dante Jackson, for the second time in a row, was stepping into a shot.
Bishop weaving in, shot blocked from behind. Derrick Brown on the run now. Has Anderson out in front, going to the rack, lays it up, tipped up and in by Brown.
Xavier's just out-hustling Cincinnati right now. Since he made a run at him, and Xavier just answered with a couple of haymakers.
Boy, did they ever. Timeout, Cincinnati. Xavier, moments ago, and it seemed like a heartbeat ago, leading by just 5 now. It's 32-19.
See the ball moving, and Jackson stepping into that shot, and then in transition. A really nice job of finding the trail man, and that was Jackson stepping into that three. And the nice transition, and Derrick Brown doing a really good job of running the floor. And one thing that Xavier's done a great job in this game of, they've defended very well, but their work on the glass has been exemplary. I think coming into this game, Sean Miller was worried more than anything about the glass. Is his team going to be able to rebound with a very good rebounding Cincinnati team? And thus far, it's been Xavier dominating the glass.
Now, for such a long stretch in this first half, Cincinnati couldn't get any offensive rhythm going. And just at the moment they had jumped back into the ball game, Xavier pounced.
And they did it from the three-point line. I mean, Derrick Brown hit that three from the corner, and then Dante Jackson two in a row. But they've done a really good job all game long defensively. And it's not like Cincinnati hasn't. Cincinnati's defended pretty well. They have had a bad stretch over the last couple of minutes. But Cincinnati has put a ton of pressure on their defense to make stops because they can't score right now.
And Xavier has crashed the glass as expected. You look at their run. They've out-rebounded Cincinnati 22-14. Vaughn up top. Williams was in early foul trouble, Jay, back on the floor.
Cincinnati needs to start making some pass fakes and shot fakes. See if they can get these Xavier defenders leaving the floor.
Vaughn trying to use the screen. The bounce, Toiloy lays it in. That was a nice give. And Steve Toiloy spent a couple of years in junior college at Miami-Dade with the bucket.
Nice use of the high ball screen.
Redford bounces for Anderson. Redford can fire it up. Won't take the shot. McLean gives off with a 7-footer freeze. Shot clock down to 11 for Xavier. Jackson knocks that one down. Sweet little 13-footer on the baseline.
He is having a great game at 13.7 assists against Auburn. But Dante Jackson has come out and really done a great job. He's really defended well, too, as he gets that steal. He's really done a great job on Deontay Vaughn.
One-on-one with Bishop, who blocked it, but right to Anderson, who lays it in. A whistle and a foul as well. Everything going Xavier's way right now, and Jackson is the driving force.
It's because they're hustling. I mean, Xavier ran back and went after that ball. They just didn't assume it was going to be made. Cincinnati assumed it, and they got burned as a result.
Crosstown Shootout, more to come, 36-21 Xavier. Brian, thanks. Our congratulations to Sam Bradford and the Heisman. Back in Cincinnati, Xavier on top here. Dave O'Brien, Jay Billis with you from the Crosstown Shootout. And Xavier, as you pointed out a couple of times, just outworking Cincinnati.
Xavier's been giving the Heisman to Cincinnati's chances to win in this game. Just a terrific performance defensively by Xavier to start this game, and they have been outworking Cincinnati, beating them on the glass, plus 9 on the glass, and they've been beating them on the offensive glass as well. It's not just all missed Cincinnati shots, and Dante Jackson has been terrific. 13 points, and he has trailed Deontay Vaughn all around, limiting him to just 5 points on 2 of 6 shooting. An outstanding performance by Deontay Vaughn.
How about that for Xavier? Second chance points, 14-2, that advantage over the Bearcats. That's a hustle number. As Vaughn will take a look at the clock. 1:20 left in the half. Now 9 to shoot it. Trying to take it up against the seven-footer. Lofted a bad pass. Anderson with the pick. And he will draw the foul by Davis. That was in front of the dunk. Now we're going to see another technical.
Now there's too much talking going on. I'll tell you what, Deontay Vaughn just threw up a lollipop up there, and C.J. Anderson is really fired up.
Now Davis.
Yeah, that was just not a good reaction by C.J. Anderson. And Carl Hess doing a good job of jumping in the middle of that. But C.J. Anderson needs to calm down right now. And some of his teammates have to get to him. He's got to listen to him. And they've got a 16-point lead right now, and they don't want to give anything to Cincinnati that Cincinnati has not earned.
Well, Cincinnati has already been hit with one technical. And now I believe there's another one that has been called. And that's going to be on C.J. Anderson of Xavier. So the T's are equal. Well, so you had a feeling eventually, Jay, it would start getting a little bit chippy.
Well, it can, but I mean, Anderson was fouled. What does he want? I mean, is he too good to get fouled? Well, he just needs to go to the free throw line and make his free throws. Now, Xavier did a terrific job defensively. They forced Deontay Vaughn into throwing another bad pass. That's his fourth turnover the first half. And Anderson took what was a very positive situation and turned it into a downer.
And so Mike Williams, the best foul shooter for Cincinnati at 85%, will shoot the technical here. 1:11 left. Now the building has not been nearly as noisy as we have known the Crosstown shootouts to be. This one tonight being played at Fifth Third Arena on the University of Cincinnati campus. About 13,000 on hand. And meanwhile, 3 miles away at the Cintas Center, the kids are loving it there. The Xavier guys and gals watching it on the big screen, and they're enjoying every minute of it so far, as well they should.
Well, they have seen their team outwork Cincinnati. And you got to give a ton of credit to what's happened in this game to Dante Jackson. Jackson has been all over Deontay Vaughn, forced him into those 4 turnovers. And Jackson was a guy that I think a lot of people were worried about. Will he be able to handle the pressure that Cincinnati was going to bring? Well, he averages about 3 assists per game, but also 3 turnovers. He's not really a true point guard. He's a combo guard, not a jet, but he has handled himself extraordinarily well in this game.
C.J. Anderson came in averaging 11. He already has 10 at the line for another one. 38-22 Xavier. He makes the pair.
And a really good move by Sean Miller to get C.J. Anderson out of the game. He can talk to him a little bit, get him to calm down, get him ready to go again. But while he's a little bit hot, get him out of the game.
I think the Cintas Center has been noisier tonight than Fifth Third Arena has.
Well, Cincinnati bending over at the waist for a loose ball. Got to get down on the floor for it. If only to send a message that you're going to fight for everything.
Vaughn gives it up here. Mitchell outside the three. Wants to shoot it. That shot harassed. Not a good one. Raymond was right in his face. 40 seconds left before halftime and a forgettable first half for Cincinnati.
Well, the Bearcats are dribbling the leather off the ball in one spot. They need to start moving the ball because I got a pretty good idea that Mick Cronin is going to tear the paint off the walls during halftime.
Vaughn on the inbounds. Toiloy double team dribbling out of that. Here's Vaughn to catch and fire, and he drains it. A three-pointer. They need a whole lot more. The second half
with better ball movement by Cincinnati, and that was a contested shot. Derrick Brown was right there with those long arms to contest that shot by Vaughn.
39-25. Xavier playing their final possession of the half. Brown thought about the three. Redford, that's off target.
Too early.
Did not take a lot off that clock. Mitchell with 5 seconds left in the half. And steps on the line and turns it over. So Xavier will have another crack at it. 15 first half turnovers for Cincinnati. It's been ugly at times. Xavier had that burst when it had tightened up to a five-point game and really stuck it to the Bearcats.
They have an opportunity here. They ought to give the ball back to Brown. Love should just catch it, give it back to Brown, let him go.
Brown with time to get it off. 1 second. Got it off in time, but can't connect. But Xavier certainly made enough with that man. Dante Jackson with 13 points. His career high is 14. He had an outstanding first half. And Xavier certainly did, too. They looked like a top 10 team. And Cincinnati against their rival for long stretches was not in the game. As we go to Ryan and Jimmy and Steve in the studio for the Dick's Sporting Goods halftime report from Cincinnati. We toss it to you guys. Getting ready for the second half, and there's a look at downtown Cincinnati and Fountain Square as they enjoy the season. Xavier enjoying the night, but at halftime, Cincinnati, the Big East football champ, celebrating that accomplishment. Brian Kelly, the Bearcats head coach, thanked the crowd. They're headed for the Orange Bowl in Miami. And defensive end Connor Barwin would have some thoughts on his crosstown rivals at Xavier.
Hey, I only got to say one thing. If Xavier
for Connor, they've got a pretty darn good basketball team.
They do have a really good basketball team. They played so well defensively. They held Cincinnati to 33% from the field, forced 14 turnovers. And I really thought the key to the first half for Xavier was Dante Jackson. He showed poise. They came after him. He only turned the ball over one time at 13 points, two steals. Did a great job on Deontay Bond. I thought that he was the guy, Dante Jackson, that really set the tone for Xavier and staked them out to the early leads.
Get it done.
Kevin Youkilis just dropped by to say hello. Boston Red Sox star. He said, for Cincinnati, it's time to get it done. And he's right about that.
Well, maybe if he can take his bat out there and start swinging it around.
That might help. Man, he can hit. And a gold glover to boot.
Well, this is the kind of rivalry this is. The mascots got into it during halftime.
it was an incident. We'll see what happens on the floor as Brown gets free, and that one slapped away by Deontay Vaughn. And isn't Vaughn the key to it for the Bearcats here in the second half?
I think he is. I think his poise and leadership have to improve in this second half. And I think Cincinnati just needs to show more fight. A really nice job by Cincinnati on the out-of-bounds to keep Xavier from getting what it wants. Now Xavier almost got an easy basket to start out the second half.
Anderson off to Love. Almost made a pass to Derrick Brown and made a couple of really smooth-looking left-handed threes in the opening half. Shot clock down to five. Raymond took a look at it, now down to two, and he knocks it down. He was out of the building.
Cincinnati did almost everything right. And B.J. Raymond showing the range that he has. And how about Mick Cronin going without the tie in the second half? The gloves are off, and so is the tie.
Gates with the handoff to Davis for three, so they answer quickly. Larry Davis with the bucket.
Now, Dave, early in the game, after the opening tap, Xavier came out with much more energy. Now the energy's even. And Cincinnati playing with it, but you wonder, is it too late? Are they going to be able to get something good to happen so they can get back in this game?
Xavier on the perimeter. Here's Raymond.
Xavier set so many back picks. You have to be alert.
Anderson floats it up there. A lot of iron. The tip won't go either. The tip missed by Jason Love.
Cincinnati got away with one. That was an easy tip. They just missed.
Vaughn fouled by Jackson as he tried to drive hard all the way to the other end. 42-28. Now the mascot's getting after it at halftime as well. There was a flag incident. And a bit of an injury from what we understand. I think everyone's actually all right, but it got a little frisky.
Well, anytime that the mascots can't get along, you know, you'd think that these guys would empathize with each other. You know, it's hot in there, and you know, the difficulties of being a mascot. Can't we all just get along?
Can't we all just is done? Deontay Vaughn at the line. Actually came in not shooting particularly well.
Anytime you break a flag,
yeah.
I mean, that's fighting time. I think we could have a lawsuit here.
And to be separated. Vaughn is 77% at the line. 42-30. And a lot of the stars, like Kevin Youkilis, who's a Cincinnati guy who came out to cheer on the Bearcats here at Fifth Third Arena, have not been happy to this point. A 12-point edge for Xavier. Brown on the baseline will bring it back out.
And now Cincinnati's starting to get out and contest things, but Yancey Gates just not used to guarding that far out on the floor, and Derrick Brown made him pay for it. Derrick Brown is a good player, and you can see that he's feeling better with that ankle. Now he struggled. He didn't score against Virginia Tech in Puerto Rico, but now he's got that bounce back in his step, and over the last three games, averaging over 18 points per game and shooting very well from the field.
Gates with a catch, draws the double team. Outside, Larry Davis, who hit that three moments ago. Vaughn wriggles in for the basket. He's starting to come to life a bit.
Unusual for Xavier. A bad closeout by Derrick Brown, and nobody came over from the weak side to get in front of Vaughn, let him get all the way to the rim from 20 feet away.
Anderson shredding that press through with the left hand, and he lays it in.
And he gets up a full head of steam. He can get to that rim, and does such a good job of posting. Strong player, transferred from Manhattan, where he was a big-time scorer there.
He was the MVP of the tournament in Puerto Rico. 47-32. It has not been close for most of the night. That's going to be an offensive foul on Yancey Gates, the big freshman. That's his fourth. Remember, he had a technical, too.
What a great job by Jason Love, making Yancey Gates catch it two steps off the lane. Look where he has to catch this ball. Instead of on the box, he's two or three steps off. Now, all of a sudden, that's a long move for Yancey Gates. Instead of just a drop step and going up strong, Love had the opportunity to jump in front of him and draw that charge. That is great post defense to push your man off the lane like that.
Anderson off to Jackson. Can't bury that one from distance, but a rebound comes to Love, and he'll draw the foul. So Jason Love really making his presence felt. He's dropped about 30 pounds since arriving on the Xavier campus from Philadelphia.
And a really good offensive rebounder. Averages about two offensive rebounds per game this year, but averaged even more last year.
And that was a stat at halftime among many that really jumped out in the Xavier success story tonight. They dominated Cincinnati on the offensive glass 11-3. At the break, as Love drops in the first.
Hey, you know, you expected Xavier to have the rebounding advantage at the half because Cincinnati shot the ball so poorly. What you didn't expect was for Xavier to dominate their offensive glass like they did. And that's really just an indication of how much harder they were going after it than Cincinnati was in that first half.
Cincinnati shot 33% in the first 20 minutes.
Game like this, Cincinnati could not afford to give Xavier a 20-minute head start, and that's exactly what they gave him. Dug a very deep hole.
Kenny Fries back on for the Musketeers, playing on the road technically, just a few miles from their campus at Xavier here in Cincinnati. It's the Crosstown Shootout. Xavier ranked number 9, taking on the Bearcats. We're really looking at this game as a game that they wanted to earn national respect and climb back into the consciousness in college basketball, as Vaughn drills that one from three.
This came off a little flare screen, and he's got more of a bounce in his step in this second half. I'll tell you what, I can't tell you how impressed I've been with Xavier, not just in this game, but all year long. And I think I've underrated this team. This is a top 10 team, and especially on the defensive end. They make it really difficult for you to score. And they do a really good job of posting their guards. They post a variety of different guys. And people say, well, Xavier doesn't have a go-to guy. But I think that might be a strength of theirs. It's a different guy every night for this Xavier team. And they've got four or five guys that can get 25 on you.
McLean on the baseline as he sealed off. Got the pass away to Raymond. And that's batted away by Vaughn. Xavier will keep it. And different guys with career highs recently. This really goes to your point, Jay. Raymond with 32 against Auburn. Brown 23 against Ohio. C.J. Anderson on the 10th of December with 22.
And there's nobody really you can key on. You know, if you watch four or five tapes of Xavier, which I did, and, you know, got a chance to see him against Miami, saw him against Missouri and all that, you know, it's hard to tell who their best player is.
they've got so many guys that can hurt you. There's nobody you can really key on the scouting report and say, hey, here's the guy we have to stop. And I think Cincinnati looked at this game saying, here are a couple guys we want to go after. But one of the guys I think they wanted to go after was Dante Jackson. He has really answered the bell.
Well, so too is Deontay Vaughn. He has 18 points and is dominating the second half here for Cincinnati. As the three-pointers continue to fall, Jackson swoops in. Collects his own miss, trying to get it back up there. Kicks out instead. Brown hands it back to him.
Smart play to get it back out in front after Jackson got the offensive rebound. Start something new.
Brown flipped that pass nearly into the backcourt, forcing a save. Cincinnati, Toilo will get there. Nicely done as he tiptoed that baseline. It's Vaughn again. He'll draw the foul before the shot. They're trying to corral Deontay Vaughn. First team all Big East. But suddenly Cincinnati has life because of him. Raymond with the foul. And we have just over 15 minutes to play. Plenty of time for the Bearcats to crawl back in. And back here in Cincinnati, where the lead has shrunk a little bit for Xavier. And Cincinnati trying to inbound. They do it to Vaughn, who has caught fire in the second half, and need a lot more of that if the Bearcats are going to spring what would be a mini upset. They were a slight underdog against Xavier. Vaughn wants it blocked away. Great stop on that effort by McLean. Shot clock at 21.
Vaughn has 10 points in the second half, and Xavier putting a little bit of size on him.
Now for about the first 8 minutes of the game, Cincinnati was frozen at 2 points. No one could score. Davis to Vaughn.
Nice pass.
Into the paint for Williams. A little bump and knocks it down.
Williams set the screen and immediately looked to be a scorer. And Vaughn delivered a nice pass. Williams got away with a little bump that could have been a charge.
Cincinnati was down 14 at half. They've shaved 5 points off that. And a crosstown shootout, which usually comes right down to the last 2 minutes.
And it could in this game. And Bishop not even guarding C.J. Anderson out on the perimeter.
Brown off the fake. Doubled up. Got through it somehow, and he will draw the foul. Terrific move just to get that foul and head to the line.
It was just a little hesitation move. And Timmy Higgins has just called another technical foul. There is way too much talking in this ball game, and it must be on Xavier, judging by the look on the face of Sean Miller.
You're right. That's the third technical this crew has whistled in this one.
Everybody needs to keep their mouths shut. Now, there's the shot fake. The shot fake got Williams up off his feet. And then the nice little hesitation. It's almost like a little turnout. And the turnout move got the defender to jump and opened up that baseline.
So Brown with the technical. So two of the T's have been on Xavier.
And do these schools not have debate teams? If you want to talk, join the debate team. You want to play, play. Nobody bought a ticket to watch these guys yet.
Let's see what he does here. Does he stick the ball in Williams' chest? And toss it to him. But Yappin. And Vaughn, a 77% foul shooter, very smooth at the line. And that makes it an 8-point game. He has 20. Talking about Deontay Vaughn, the junior from Indianapolis, who did not start in their win over UAB. They brought him off the bench instead.
Well, Mick Cronin wanting him to show some leadership, and he has been struggling shooting the ball a little bit. He's not struggling in the second half. He's been perfect. He's playing with a lot more energy. But right now, the word for both teams has to be poise. Cincinnati has fought their way back into this game, and Xavier, on a couple of occasions, have lost their poise.
The Davis foul putting Brown to the line, where he hits 73%. Brown, also an outstanding defender. He'll be graduating in May. He's only a junior. ...51-42 Xavier. Both teams very good at the line here tonight. Another whistle off the ball. And a hold on Raymond. And he cannot believe it. DJ Raymond a little upset.
Well, after Deontay Vaughn gives the ball up, he just comes off this little rub back screen, and sometimes he will clear to the other side and come off a baseline screen. Sometimes he just pops back off the same guy he rubbed off of.
He just committed his third foul.
There he goes off the screen now and just pops back. And that's how he got the foul on Raymond a minute ago. Then beautiful pass.
But a better block from behind by Love, and also off of Cincinnati.
Just a terrific job after the screen, little flare screen, heading right to the basket. And a nice little slip off that screen, and Love there to block it.
Williams tried to keep it in play, was off his hand. Pressure here by the Bearcats. They double up on Raymond, and traveling.
The last place, Dave, that you want to catch the ball is in that corner. Rick Pitino calls that the coffin corner. You have the two defenders in red shirts, and then the sideline and baseline act as two more defenders, and you are absolutely trapped.
Back over to Cincinnati. Raymond hits the bench. And another whistle. And a blocking foul here will go against the Bearcats. So every time tonight, it's only been a handful of occasions, Jay, where it looked like Cincinnati was going to go on a run, a whistle or a little mini run by Xavier has halted it.
You know, it's funny. People want to blame the referees for blowing that whistle, but the players know what the referees are calling them. They've got to adjust to it, and they've got to make sure they set a good screen. They've got to make sure they set their man up to use that screen so they don't pick up a cheap one.
Holloway to drive. Popped up the pass, which is batted into the corner. Brown tried to save it, can't. Back over to Cincinnati it goes. So both sides have got a little bit sloppy with 13:45 left here at Fifth Third Arena.
Right now there's a premium on being strong with the ball, catching, facing, and making a play.
16 Cincinnati turnovers. Vaughn wants to drive, throw, laid it high off the window and fouled. Now he's taking command virtually every time down the floor.
He's just got a different look on his face in the second half than he did on the first. I thought Cincinnati came out tentative in the first half. It's almost like they were trying to see what was going to happen instead of, you know, delivering contact, delivering a blow, which is what Xavier did. And Xavier just outworked Cincinnati in the first half. In the second half, it's been more of an even fight, but I'd give the edge in the work rate to Cincinnati.
Yeah, mainly because of the man at the line, Deontay Vaughn. Jason Love fouled him, number two on Love.
Vaughn has been near perfect in this second half.
And look at all the scoring he has done. He had not scored 20 in a game yet this season as Cincinnati's top player. Now trying for 22. 51-44.
We saw another great scorer today. Deontay Christmas of Temple had only 5 points in the first half against Tennessee, then came out and put 30 up in the second half.
Vaughn at 8 points at halftime. Gates in foul trouble. One of those four, a technical. We've had three technical fouls in this contest.
Wilkes not even guarding Anderson on the perimeter.
Holloway backs away. 15 to shoot it. A lot of dribbling. Slices that pass into Anderson. Got an excellent look. Could not connect. Rebounded back to Xavier. Brown threatening a three.
He is good with fakes and with jab steps. He needs to continue to do that to keep the defense off balance.
Brown to work. Trying to work on Davis. Dribbled off his own foot. And out of bounds. Back to Cincinnati it goes. 11 turnovers for Xavier. Tuesday night, ESPN, ESPN2. A doubleheader. First at 7. It'll be South Florida taking on Vanderbilt on ESPN2. Then 9:30, ESPN brings you Marquette and Tennessee. Now, Bishop has just been whistled for a technical foul, the fourth of the game by the two teams combined.
Yeah, you almost think, Dave, how many technicals do the referees have to call before the players get it into their heads. Shut up and play. It's not that hard.
I'm guessing it's at least four. And he'll walk right by. And there it is. He was mouthing off there to Dante Jackson. And the crew heard it. As mentioned, this is a tremendous crew. Tim Higgins, John Cahill, and Carl Hess with 72 years of officiating experience at Division I. These are personal fouls now. 53-44.
Cincinnati was able to cut this lead to seven. And just because one player was yakking too much, they give up 2 points. It's crazy.
Vaughn in and out with his jumper. Got the shot he wanted. Brown in close. And it's tipped up and in by Love. Love got up there high over all the red shirts. He has five.
And Love was able to do that from behind a Cincinnati player. He was just able to go up over him.
Davis a three. That would have made the place pretty noisy. They keep it alive, however. Bishop, awkward shot. That didn't touch anything. Cincinnati with another effort. They got three cracks at it, Jay.
Just the lid on the basket right now for Cincinnati.
12-01 remaining here in the second half. You can see some frustration seeping in on Bishop's face there and some of the other Bearcats.
Well, a lot of the air went out of this building with that technical foul.
It really did.
And that was a big play in this game and a big play for the Cincinnati comeback. That was a bad shot by Derrick Brown.
Bishop with the rebound. Cincinnati 6-1. Xavier undefeated at 8-0 and ranked number 9 coming in. Xavier has never lost when they've been nationally ranked in this game, the Crosstown Shootout.
Dante Jackson back on Vaughn. He did such a good job on him in the first half.
Toy Loy back to Dixon. Wants to get a little bit closer and nails it.
Smart play by Toy Loy to give that ball up. Looked like because he was open, he felt like he was entitled to shoot it. That would have been a bad opportunity. Bad place to take it for Brown.
Love runs into the lane with a catch. Here's Raymond straight on. Too strong. Vaughn bats the rebound right to a teammate.
All of a sudden, Xavier settling for jump shots, and they are quick ones. They are not making Cincinnati guard.
Vaughn with a spin. He kicks out. Three-pointer. And again, there was an opportunity for Cincinnati just to tear the roof off the place with a big three. They'll win it back here with 11 minutes to go. But unable to hit that big shot. Coming up when we return to Fifth Third Arena, Zip It will explain. Come on back.
You talking to me? Xavier leading Cincinnati by 9, and in a highly charged rivalry like Cincinnati Xavier, sometimes tempers get the best of players, and we have seen it in this game. There have been 4 technicals called, guys whooping, too many confrontations, unsportsmanlike actions taken by players, and it's really, not only has it put the teams in a bad spot, and you can see right here Rashad Bishop just whooping too much at Dante Jackson, picking up another technical when Cincinnati was down 7, they had the ball, and all of a sudden they allow Xavier to score 2 points, move it back up to 9. Now it was just point of interruption. Cincinnati got the ball back, but it's just ridiculous that you would take your team out of a good spot with your mouth. Both teams need to show better poise.
And how much is this up to the head coaches right now to corral their teams in that regard?
Well, they both need to do it. But I think the officials have done a pretty darn good job. What a great catch and shoot by Dante Vaughn.
Vaughn is having himself quite a ball game here. And Cincinnati has only turned it over once in the second half. They pulled it within 6. They had 14 turnovers at halftime. Love into the double team. He's fouled on the deck with 10:38 left. And really looking for the big guy, the 6'9 junior, Jason Love.
You see Bishop taking it over to the right side of the floor, and off of a baseline screen came Dante Vaughn, set those feet awfully quickly and squared up to the basket. When I say squared up, some people think of the shoulders being squared to the basket, which is part of it, but one of the things I like is the idea of having all 10 toes pointed at the rim, making sure that you square your body with your feet.
Toiloy's second foul, 1-1 time for Xavier. And Love connects on that one. By the way, 25 points for Deonte Vaughn, who has been lighting it up here in the second half. Five on the night for Love.
And this lead, this free throw is made. I mean, it's an 8-point game, but when you take away some of these stupid technicals that Cincinnati got in this ball game, they would be right in this game.
That's Mike Williams, who is hurt, and he did it defending. Mike, who turned 23 years old in November, transferred from Texas, then got hurt, and was really just starting to pull things together back to when he was a McDonald's All-American out of Alabama. Toiloy all the way in for the dunk. Steve Toiloy slams it down, and this is a 6-point game. Quick to the rack and stuffed it. 10-17 left.
A momentum play for Cincinnati. And now they need to back it up with great defense.
Raymond cross court. Jackson, who had a big first half, he's been pretty quiet here in the second half.
What an impressive comeback by Cincinnati.
Brown working to the baseline around Dixon. Oh, and a tough move. Almost an impossible angle.
And it was all set up with a little jab step. He took a jab step toward the lane, got the defender to bite on it, and that opened up the baseline. Terrific move by Derrick Brown.
Gorgeous. He is 14.
And he is so good with fakes, especially those foot fakes, little jab steps.
Vaughn again. Toiloy. And one. Vaughn creating for the big fella.
Toiloy with the ball at the high post. Nobody guarding him. And Freeze way too slow to get up there to stop that drive. And here's the jab step. And gets that baseline. Here's Toiloy. Terrific drive by Deonte Vaughn along the baseline. Through two defenders, and that left Toiloy wide open underneath, and a bad mistake to foul.
That was Jackson's second foul, and Toiloy showing up here in the second half. He has seven. More pressure now from the Bearcats.
Not only the pressure, but game pressure now. Now we got a ball game again, and now every shot has pressure on it.
Raymond breaks it on the dribble, but of course that's how Cincinnati under Bob Huggins played, that relentless defense, that relentless rebounding. Top 25 team year after year, they're trying to get that back. Jackson, too strong. Bishop with the rebound.
And that's what I meant by game pressure, Dave. In the first half, that shot was a lot easier than now.
Dixon. Williams tipped the rebound, and that is going to be off Xavier. And Williams able to keep that alive.
Cincinnati is now fighting. They are fighting for every rebound, every loose ball, and that has gotten them back into it.
Love rocks this
Well, we expected here in the Crosstown Shootout this kind of fever pitch all night. We've finally gotten it. Both of these teams combined are 14-1. That's the best winning percentage since 1958, when this Crosstown Shootout started going to one game a year against one another, a 9.33 winning percentage. And Cincinnati, behind Deonte Vaughn and his 25 points, have thrust themselves into this one. Finally.
A tough place to catch it.
Toilet, and there's a timeout by Cincinnati rather than risk the turnover.
Possession more important.
And we mentioned the success of the junior Vaughn, who's been cooking.
Last three games, Deonte Vaughn shot only 30% from the field, even though he is averaging over 16 points per game over that stretch. But in this second half, he has been magnificent. He's played with a great deal of confidence. And I think his play has really staked his team out to this comeback. You know, Cincinnati did not play well in the first half. I don't think they played as hard as Xavier. In the second half, it's been Cincinnati that's played harder, and that's why they're right back in this thing.
So now the counter on Vaughn for Xavier. Who's their go-to guy? You talked about the fact that it's a strength. They don't have just one.
That's right. And I don't think they do have a go-to guy, one guy they can throw the ball to that he can go get a shot. I think they get it off of their offense. But, you know, you got to think that Derrick Brown is a guy they're going to look to, and also C.J. Anderson, to try to get the ball, something going to the basket. And C.J. Anderson is excellent at attacking the rim. But the guy who often hits the biggest shots for Xavier is B.J. Raymond. You remember last year in the NCAA tournament against West Virginia, when that game was on the line, he hit two gigantic threes.
Navon has been a shot maker in the second half here on his home floor.
The zone right now for Xavier. They've gone exclusively man in this game. Now going with a little zone off the out of bounds.
Dixon gives it up to Vaughn.
Got to penetrate this off the dribble. You can't just pass it around the perimeter and then launch up a shot.
Well, losing a lot of time here. Seven to get off a shot now. Here's Dixon as he draws a liner. But again, it's Toloi, the man on the spot. What a second half he's having.
Well, it's almost like the zone prevented Xavier from getting blockout responsibilities. That was just too easy to give up that kind of second shot.
Well, the closest Cincinnati has been in a long, long time since the opening moments of the game. Anderson gives it up to Brown.
There's that little cross screen on the block and their thumb upset.
Slapped away by Bishop. A scramble on the deck. Toloi won it back. He's coming up big on both ends. Vaughn on a dribble drive. Bishop is free. Off the window, not there, too strong.
Well, Cincinnati didn't score, Dave, but that's the difference in the second half. They are getting on the floor for loose balls instead of bending over at the waist.
Raymond to the paint. Great dish. Love denied. Blocked by Williams, and now the foul with 7:40 to go. Cincinnati relentlessly defending.
Well, everything is contested now. We've got a one-possession game because Cincinnati has brought the fight in the second half.
Williams with his fourth foul on this play. 7:40 left.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Best Buy. You happier.
Armory Fieldhouse on the Cincinnati campus. Oscar Robertson used to play there. We are back inside Fifth Third Arena as Cincinnati Gardens held the most Crosstown Shootout games, as Cincinnati went 27-15 against Xavier there. And a look at the series history. First meeting in 1928, then in 1958 they started to go to one time a year. Xavier has won 8 of the last 12, and tonight, Jay, looked like they were sailing to a pretty easy win. They had a 14-point lead at halftime, but Cincinnati has come roaring back.
Well, Cincinnati just came out with more fight in the second half. They started defending, and Deontay Vaughn caught fire. He is their best player and best scorer. And when he plays like this, Cincinnati is going to be a tough out for anybody. You just wonder, though, Dave, with being so far behind in the first half and having to expend so much energy to get back in this game, whether Cincinnati will have enough in the tank to be able to perhaps finish this off.
Now, Mick Cronin will not be weighed down by the tie around his neck. He lost that at halftime, probably during a tirade laying into his team, as you predicted he might, and he came back without the tie. And they pull out a win here tonight, which would be a little bit of an upset, even though it's on Cincinnati's home floor. Xavier is the favorite. He may never wear a tie again.
That would especially be an upset given the lead that they staked Xavier out to in the first half. B.J. Raymond sticking right with Deontay Vaughn. Good closeout with using his length and size advantage.
Vaughn, quick dribble, fires. And a little too strong on this occasion.
That's just not a good shot. Even though he's feeling it, that was a contested jump shot. And they need to move the ball and make Xavier guard him. The big possession right now for Xavier.
Sean Miller calling out a play. Fifth-year head coach who won 30 games last year. A school record at Xavier, and they went on to the Elite Eight. Brown, shot clock down to 9. Raymond sees it, catches, fires. Shots not falling on either side. Gates is back on. Yancey Gates in foul trouble with 4. He had that rebound. Bishop outside. Each side has been hit with a pair of technicals. Vaughn on the baseline. Tried to lay it up high over Brown. Here's Anderson. And they've got some numbers. Anderson all the way in. Lays it up and in for two.
Xavier did such a nice job of getting that outlet pass out and running. And Cincinnati looked a little bit tired in transition. Nobody really got back. And I think the gas in the tank is going to be a big issue down the stretch.
Vaughn almost looked like he went for a little walk there. It was not called. Here's Bishop. Got it from close range.
How about that catch and the body control to get a shot off? And a pretty darn good shot.
And Bishop really has the ability to change a game. He was instrumental in Cincinnati's upset of Pitt last January. Coming off the bench. 63-58. Coming up on 5.5 minutes remaining here at Fifth Third Arena. Brown, well outside the three. Here's B.J. Raymond. He can hit the three-pointer. He's at 40%. That's going to be an offensive foul as he shoved off on Deontay Vaughn. And that's number four.
Good call. Just brought up that right arm. And pushed off, and when the defender went down, it looked like the referee let it go early, but once the defender went down, he had to make the call.
So Raymond with four fouls. He came in averaging 13 points a game. So he's been held down, and foul trouble a big part of that. 5:23 to go. Do the Bearcats have enough left to come all the way back? A key man on the bench now for Xavier.
And B.J. Raymond has also been a key defender. He spent quite a bit of time on Deontay Vaughn trying to use his size against him. And now Dante Jackson will go back on to Vaughn, who did such a good job on him in the first half, limited him to 8 points.
Vaughn with Jackson on him. Williams hands off back to Vaughn. Under the legs, he spins in the lane, lifts it up. And maybe he's getting a little bit weary, but he won back the rebound. Underneath 5 minutes left here. Williams wants it. Shot's not going down now for the Bearcats. And Jay, I think you're exactly right. Expending all that energy down 14 and a half to pull to within three. Now it's five, and the shots are not going down.
Cincinnati just has tired looks on their faces, and now Xavier's got to make them guard for the full clock unless they get a layup.
Bishop with a reach and a foul for 32 to go. Hey, coming up on Sunday, our Bowl Mania special, 8:30 Eastern time. Anything and everything you want to know. The game day crew makes their picks. Todd McShay identifies a few under the radar NFL prospects to watch during bowl season. That's tomorrow night on ESPN at 8:30. 63-58 timeout. We've had 8 offensive fouls in this game and 4 technical fouls. There's probably a loose tooth or two rolling around on the deck here.
Well, I know there are an awful lot of interested observers that have spent a lot of time around this rivalry. You know that the entire staff at Wake Forest is sitting at home watching this game. Dino Gaudio, Pat Kelsey, Jeff Battle, guys that have worn the Xavier blue. And I'm sure Bob Huggins is watching this game as well. And Pete Gillen. And this rivalry's in your blood. And there have been so many great coaches and players that have been with this rivalry for years and years and made it what it is.
Well, Mick Cronin is a Cincinnati kid. He was born and raised here. His father, Harold, a tremendous high school coach here. Over 400 wins. He's watching his boy coaching at the University of Cincinnati. Harold, one of the very best here. And Sean Miller has talked about what a thrill it is for him on the Xavier side to coach in this series. And Sean Miller recently won his 100th game at Xavier. So two really fine young coaches who figured to be in this rivalry for a long time. Look at the coaches. Bob Stack started the turnaround. And then Pete Gillen, who caught the nation's attention with six NCAA appearances. Then it was Skip Fosser with six postseason bursts. And Thad Mata, only three seasons, but he capped it off with an elite eight appearance in 04.
I just hope Pete Gillen got rid of those glasses.
That hair got higher back then, didn't it? That was the look.
Thad Mata, I'm sure, watching the game. And John Gross, the head coach at Ohio U.
Brown back to the basket. Demanding the ball, and he lost it. Here's Vaughn. Dribbles in, the leaner swatted away. Great job on that occasion by Jamel McLean. And now a traveling violation by Bishop.
You got to give credit to Derrick Brown with that closeout on Bishop for forcing that travel. And Xavier really got back. Holloway there to try to take a charge. And then, boy, McLean is such a great athlete. Jamel McLean, that is a high flyer. Almost hit his head on the backboard.
Transfer from the University of Tulsa, 63-58. Coming up on the 4-minute mark.
Really important now for Xavier to force Cincinnati to play defense. Use the clock. You want to continue to be aggressive, but you don't want to take a quick, cheap one.
Brown turning on Williams. Williams is playing with four. Flips it up with the left hand. Freeze going up and foul. The crowd wanted a traveling violation in the worst way. They do not get it. The hack came first. 3:49 left. Bishop with his fourth. And Corona not happy. He wanted that travel. Crosstown Shootout, Cincinnati, the home of Skyline Chili. Right by campus, this is the original. Cincinnati really known for great chili. And when you order chili, however you get it, Jay Billis, just a little bit of cheese is the best way to go. Just a slight bit of cheese.
Well, the Italian side of my immediate family might find chili over spaghetti to be blasphemous. But
not here.
They love it here.
Kenny Freeze at the line.
This young man's going to be a good player. Really good hands, just needs to get stronger and needs to get a go-to move in the post. He's got a pretty nice move over his left shoulder and needs to get something over his right shoulder, but he's got a chance to be a really fine player.
Keenan averaging 5 points and five rebounds and rolls in the first one.
Derrick Brown is getting back, I think, to where I expected him to be from the beginning of the year when he suffered that ankle injury, and that slowed him down. But that young man is a really, really fine basketball player. And I think he's going to get better and better.
Amazing. Xavier has all the fast break points in this game. 12 of them. Cincinnati does not have a point on a fast break.
Now, Xavier's transition defense has been very, very good. They get back with a sense of purpose. They communicate. And you don't get anything easy against Xavier.
He called a timeout in time. Cronin did not want, he wanted to take, obviously, with 3:29 to go. But to save the turnover, Vaughn was about to be tied up. And so Cincinnati with one timeout remaining, and Xavier has two with 3 minutes and 29 seconds to play here. Xavier unyielding. They were up 14 at half. Cincinnati has gotten to within three on several occasions. Over the last 25 seasons of Xavier basketball, look at the winning percentage. 24 winning seasons in the last 5 years, Jake. Two trips to the Elite Eight.
You know what I think's funny, Dave? People call Xavier a mid-major, which I think is crazy. I just don't see it. Gonzaga is no longer referred to as a mid-major. People say, well, they're out of the mid-major conversation because of how successful they are. If you look at Xavier and what they've done, they've been more successful than Gonzaga has. I mean, they've been to two Elite Eights in this decade, 04 and 08. And over the last 20 years, Xavier's been one of the better programs in the country. They've accomplished more over that stretch than Gonzaga has. So if Gonzaga's out of that conversation, Xavier's got to be out of it as well.
Xavier pressuring on the inbounds. Gates blocked right back in his face. Love is a terrific shot blocker. Holloway out front now. It's five on the night for the Musketeers.
Well, Xavier just has a number of players that do what it takes to win. They're not guys that are going to jump out at you on the stat sheet, and Jason Love is one of those, but they make winning plays during the course of a ballgame.
Raymond up top for Brown, off the fake, gets a little bit closer, dumps it down low and off the hand of Love, and they turn it over less than 3 minutes to play. 15 turnovers for Xavier.
He needed to shoot that ball. I mean, Derrick Brown makes great use of shot fakes, and he has done it all game long. And he lifted up and got the defender to fly, and he needed to take that shot in the lane.
That needle for Cincinnati just about on empty as Brown forces the turnover, and he's fouled. He'll be shooting. 2:39 to play.
Cincinnati has had their chances in this game. They worked hard, got back into it, but that's just not being strong with the ball by Mike Williams. Got a little bit of pressure, but he was too straight up and down. He needed to pivot around and deliver the ball. You got to be strong with it, especially in this situation.
Vaughn fouls, and he's frustrated. Brown to the line at 73%. Derrick Brown out of Dayton, Ohio, and you've heard this before. He calls LeBron James the toughest player he's ever faced. Has been said more than once.
Well, he faced LeBron James this summer at the Nike Skills Academy, and I thought Derrick Brown really did a nice job there. I was one of the instructors there and got a chance to work with him and watch him. And now, that was the first time he had been to anything like that and came away a much more confident player. And you can see in the results that he's had during the season, he's a much better player this year than he was last year.
Great word for how he's played tonight. He has 18 points, very confident.
And look how many free throws they've shot.
And there he is again. Takes it right away from Dixon. On the dribble, draws more contact. Derrick Brown is just a half step to a full step quicker than anybody Cincinnati has right now on the floor.
Well, Cincinnati's just not strong with the ball and not delivering it. They've got to do a much better job. You know, there's plenty of time left in this game, but I just think they've run out of gas.
Now Bishop has just fouled out. Brown back to the stripe. Preseason all A-10 first team. They could really use Cashmere Wright, but he is injured.
Boy, this young man, Cashmere Wright, tore his ACL, and you know, he had an opportunity, I think, to be a real difference maker for this Cincinnati team, because he would come in, stabilize the point position. Deontay Vaughn could be off the ball. He would have made a huge difference to the Bearcats' chances this year.
Cashmere Wright out for the season. Red shirts after the torn left ACL. But an all-everything out of Savannah, Georgia. And will not play for Cincinnati until next season. So Brown shooting again with 2.5 minutes to go. 18 points tonight. He has two shots.
Yeah, I worry a bit about Wright not having the name for the Big East, you know? Cashmere?
Yeah.
Sounds a little too hoity-toity for the Big East.
For the rough-and-tumble Big East.
Yeah, I mean, I just finished doing a game with West Virginia, and they've got a young man as a freshman named Truck Bryant. Like, you know, he's going to fit into the Big East. You know, there are no guards named Speedy in the Big East. They had to change his name to 100% Wool or Steel Wool or something like that.
68-58, 20 points for Brown. He's been a star tonight for Xavier. They seem to have a different star every night. Here's Vaughn. He's had such a huge second half. Gates. Vaughn wants to shoot so desperately on the drive. That shot didn't touch anything. Too well defended.
Well, Xavier just stayed solid. You know, five guys showing their chest to the ball. Everybody in good help side position communicating, and they cleaned it up after the miss.
Now an opportunity for Xavier to run some clock here. Up 10 with a minute 47 to play. That one's going to fall down, and they extend that lead. Jay, I think you nailed it. When they got to within three, Cincinnati expended so much energy to do it. They don't appear to have anything left. Xavier is rolling.
They're on empty, but I'll tell you, Xavier is a terrific basketball team. And this is a team that has answered every challenge this season to have that goose egg in the loss column, and things aren't going to get any easier. I mean, this team has really tested itself. They're playing Duke in the Meadowlands on December 20th, and then right before Christmas, having a chance to play Butler. And Butler was beaten today by Ohio State in a great game. You know, Butler is an outstanding team, and this non-conference record that Xavier set up for themselves is really going to put them in a great position with the NCAA Tournament Selection Committee, not only to get a great seed, but to be prepared when they get to the tournament, because they played the best teams and they played all different kinds of styles. You know, already they played Missouri that presses and gets you into an up and down game, and they played Miami of Ohio, which is like going to the dentist. I mean, everything, it's like a crusade to score every time down. Charlie Coles does a great job with that team. But I think I've underrated Xavier. This is a much better team than I think I gave credit for earlier in the season.
Now, they've beaten Virginia Tech. They've beaten Memphis. As you mentioned, they have Duke coming up in the Cintas Center. They have loved it so far tonight. And it looks like they're going to love it well into the evening. This 8-0 start, Xavier's best since 96-97. When they started out 10-0, the Musketeer fans are going to hang in, and the Bearcat fans are headed for the exits. At least a lot of them are. Coming up next, the 2008 PRCA National Finals Rodeo, which Jay never misses. Minute 40 to go here. Xavier, the number 9 team in the country.
Number 19, and they'll be moving up. Especially with Tennessee losing today.
Bond giving it up. 1:30 left. Dixon on the spin. Foul, and he laid it in. A pretty move there by Deion Dixon, the freshman.
It looked like Dixon had gotten himself in some trouble with that spin against the pressure, but he's got such good ball skills, he was able to get that in, coming off a pretty darn good game against UNLV at 13 points, a few rebounds, and Cincinnati got him late out of Chicago, and a really good get.
And Dante Jackson had the big first half for Xavier, 13 points. He's not scored in the second half, and they're such an interesting team with so many options, they really haven't missed that scoring. Here's Vaughn, that missed badly. Minute 20 to go, and a foul.
What is wrong with these guys?
Another technical. Right. Another one.
Well, that drives you crazy, and I think Sean Miller is going to have to address that. You know, you want to almost say to Derek, son, are you too good to get fouled? You just grabbed a rebound, and you're being tough with it, and somebody fouled you, and you get to walk to the line and make two free throws. Show some poise. There's a minute 20 left in this game. You know, you give up a couple free throws and you miss yours. They hit a three, and all of a sudden you got a problem.
Well, he's done. That's his second one.
Now watch this. Gets the rebound, and he got fouled. What, do you want a medal? Somebody fouled you. So what? Walk to the free throw line, make your free throws, and go home a winner. I don't get these guys.
Five technicals for the two teams combined tonight in this Crosstown Shootout. And Xavier on top by 10 points, 70-60. Now the crew has decided, and did decide very early, they were not going to take all the lip. Higgins, Cahill, and Hess. And they've really buckled down on it.
Well, you'd think after a couple of technicals get called, you can understand a guy woofing and going over the line the first time. I mean, this has been going on the whole game. And especially for something like that. What did the guy do? It's late in the game, and you grab a rebound, and somebody fouls you 90 feet from the basket. I mean, you should be getting together with your teammates going, all right, let's knock these down and put this thing out of reach. Instead, you grab a tough defensive rebound, and Cincinnati gets to score first. That's crazy.
So Vaughn, we've seen this parade of technical foul shots throughout the night, unfortunately. So Derrick Brown ejected, and then really had a marvelous night until now. 20 points and 10 rebounds.
And Brown still in the building. Now he's walking out. He needs to get out of here.
He has been ejected.
Since he has been ejected, they get to choose somebody to shoot the free throws in his stead. And it's going to be Brad Redford, who shot 97% in high school and once made 102 in a row.
State of Michigan, Mr. Basketball, averaged 37 points a game his senior year in high school. 120 to play. And Xavier in the process pretty much putting this one out of reach. And now an official timeout. I'm going to take a look at the monitor here. So yet another delay here before we can finish it up at Fifth Third Arena. You wonder what this is going to do to what appeared to be Xavier momentum in the final moment. Some of the fans were beginning to leave. John Cahill, Tim Higgins, Carl Hess. Now here to chat with Sean Miller. Redford waiting for a chance to shoot again. Hey, coming up Tuesday night on ESPN2 and ESPN, you can catch a college hoops doubleheader from the Big East SEC Invitational. That's coming up from Nashville. First at 7 Eastern on ESPN2. South Florida takes on Vanderbilt. And then at 9:30 Eastern on ESPN, Marquette squares off against Tennessee. The Volunteers losing today in an upset. And now the officials are going to converse at the scoring table. Go back and look at the time and see if they have it right on the clock. That's what we are being told from the scorer's table. That's what John Cahill was looking at.
That comes off with what, 120? There's the foul, 120.
Seemed to be when it was called. And then he said, Timmy Higgins jump in with that technical, the fifth of the game. So we have a delay here while they sort that out. I guess now what they're looking at is whether or not somebody entered the game illegally. If it was Jason Love of Xavier, if he went into the game illegally. ...71-62 Xavier trying to put this one to bed tonight here at Cincinnati. It's taking a little bit longer than they had hoped. Cincinnati, by the way, tonight committing 26 fouls. That is a season high for the Bearcats.
Problem is, too many of them were technical.
Cincinnati coming back onto the floor here. 1 minute, 20 seconds to play. Redford getting his second shot.
Hey, these games between Cincinnati and Xavier are never pretty. But this one was an especially bumpy ride.
Lead back up to 10. And we have had an ejection. As Derrick Brown got the boots. Jumping in Wilkes, he's denied. A scrum. And Wilkes winds up getting tied up. Possession arrow will keep it on this end with 1:08 to go.
Xavier gone to his zone on that possession.
And Terrell Holloway, the freshman, is back on the floor, and Redford comes off. So he did his part tonight, hitting the free throws. Into Dixon. The one-hander. So many shots left short here in the second half. Not by that guy. Steve Toloy's actually played a marvelous second half.
Yeah, he really has had a nice second half. He's been active, been on the glass, and he's finished plays.
11 points for Toloy, and he had 2 at halftime. Another whistle with 57.2 seconds remaining.
Holloway did a nice job of splitting that double team and picking up the foul. And now it's up to Xavier to step to the free throw line, knock their free throws down. They have been living at the line. And they have four different guys that average more than four free throw attempts per game. And as a team, average about 35 free throw attempts per game. If they can raise their free throw percentage, as a team they shoot about 66%, give or take, that line can really be a weapon for this Xavier team.
25 out of 30 tonight. And another one by Holloway on this occasion. He's a 96% foul shooter. And he had made 23 consecutive foul shots coming into tonight. And nothing but net. 74-64 Xavier. Under a minute to play here. Just not enough of Deontay Vaughn in the end as Davis doesn't hit anything. Harassed from behind by Raymond. And another foul on a night that has seen the whistles at times really take over.
A much better reaction on the part of Xavier after that foul. They got together as a team. Instead of reacting.
The foul on Wilkes is fourth. 45 seconds remaining. Paxson has had a very, very good night.
Well, he started off the game so positively. Cincinnati trying to go after Dante Jackson, who averages about three turnovers per game, to see if he can take the heat, see if he can cough it up. Only one turnover in the first half. He had 13 points, knocked down three three-point field goals. And that really set the tone for Xavier in the first half. He hasn't scored in the second half, but his play in the first half really staked Xavier out to their lead. And in the second half, C.J. Anderson, Derrick Brown, all did a nice job. Jason Love did a good job, especially on the glass and defensively.
I saw Dante laughing, joking with Carl Hess, one of the officials. Nice to see somebody smiling out here after all the fouls and the five technicals and an ejection. Not exactly what we had in mind when we talk about this being such a fun and intense rivalry. Although physical play is always part of it.
But it's fun for us. I don't know how fun it is for the players.
And
it's a battle.
Mitchell around and out from three-point land. Love with the rebound. And with just about a half minute left, another reach and another foul. This one by Larry Davis to stop the clock. But Xavier on top, 76-64. In case you just joined us tonight, Jay Billis, a lot of chattering, and not just by you and I.
Yeah, way too much talk by the players and too many bad reactions. You know, C.J. Anderson getting fouled and immediately getting into the face of a player. And you can see here, Rashad Bishop, they're having too much to say to Dante Jackson, and referees right on top of it trying to keep control of this game. In a game of high emotion that can get out of control, referees tried to seize control of it. No, it's the fault of the players. And after the first technical foul, everybody's on notice and on warning. And, you know, I thought the reaction by Derrick Brown was the one that was most surprising. I mean, just a simple little foul and decided to jump back in the face of the opposing player. It was totally unnecessary. The kind of thing that the loss of poise that could have affected the outcome of the game in different spots.
Dixon tipped in that miss. On Vaughn's drive is Raymond. 13 seconds left. And Xavier can start to celebrate a victory over their crosstown rivals, the Cincinnati Bearcats, on Cincinnati's home floor. It'll be Cincinnati's first home loss of the season. And Xavier remains perfect. The Musketeers now 9-0. A solid effort in many respects, but too many technical fouls and one ejection in this one. 76-66. Xavier wins it. Coming up next, the PRCA National Finals Rodeo. And for continuing coverage of our game, tune into ESPN News. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Jay Billis, I'm Dave O'Brien. Thanks so much.